Good morning, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to start by telling you a little bit about the foundation and why I am at this forum. The foundation, the group, is a financial services provider with, at its core, championing socioeconomic prosperity of the people of Africa. And we, the foundation, which I run and manage, is one in this family of institution with one very specific mandate: to be able to transform people's lives socially, economically. In Africa, social is a big deal, and that sits in the way of economic transformation. So that's our job, is to look at the social challenges. But in this family, where we sit with a bank, this bank which started really because it was propelled by farmers, has become the largest bank in the region. And what is most important is that it has grown its customer base from about 400,000 to 9.6 million over a period of 10 years. Now, why is that important? In order to serve those customers, it has had to innovate, it has had to become very technologically astute. It has had to find mobile technology. It has had to do very many things in order to serve this fast-growing customer base. And that is what has been the advantage for the foundation. So what we have at our disposal is a trusted entity, is an entity that's a huge infrastructure that we can rely on to touch the lives of people. And over the last few years, the foundation has been able, because of access to this large infrastructure, we have been able to train, for example, 1.2 million women and youth in financial literacy. We have been able to touch the lives of 500,000 farmers. We have been able to deploy loans of up to $270 million to women entrepreneurs. And it shows the power of what you can do when you bring private enterprise and social impact institutions together. The foundation itself works in seven areas, and those areas are intended to provide opportunity, capacity, and really to empower people. So take the example of agriculture. If you want a farmer to become prosperous, they have to be able to manage their money. We use a financial literacy program. They have to manage a business. We use the entrepreneurship program. They have to worry about environmental concerns, and we've had about environment and the challenges of environment. We have environment as one of our programs. And really what I'm saying here is that we integrate. We have a multifaceted approach that is designed to help this farmer, because all the poor people, because we believe that social challenges are multifaceted in nature. So why are we here in an agriculture congress, in an agriculture conference? Because, as somebody said, in the orchestra, you need many players. And I believe you are one of those players in the orchestra. Africa, we're talking about feeding 9 billion people. Africa has not yet managed to feed itself. Yet, paradoxically, it has the largest land that's fertile for agriculture that's currently unexploited. So it's a paradox that you have so much land, you have so much technology, land and agriculture has been transformed in the world, but yet we have this continent that's not been able to feed itself first. So we are taking that challenge, and we are starting in Kenya, our own country, where the bank was founded. And we know that in that country, we ourselves have not been able to feed ourselves. We are food insecure, we're nutritionally insecure, we have low incomes. And the challenges are around climate, they're around the farm sizes, and many that face both the sector and the farmer themselves. So what the foundation has done, although I've said we've targeted and already worked with 500,000 farmers, we know the challenge is larger. So what we've done is designed a new pilot with support of one of our partners, the Dutch government. And what that is doing is looking at a multiplicity of services that we want to provide to this farmer, and they have to do with production knowledge, they have to do with services, they have to do with products, they have to do with a trust network that is going to help us to create, to deliver on-time support, consistent messaging to the farmer. But ultimately, what we really want is to make sure that this farmer can become prosperous in a sustainable manner. We're also designing this for sustainability. What development does is talks to a farmer, works with him for 3 years, and goes away. Behavior change is absolutely essential to transformation. And so what we are designing is a sustainable model that is going to look at price. It is going to look at sustainability to the farmer in terms of the longevity of the impact. But most importantly, it's also going to look at environmental sustainability. As you saw from the challenges, climate is a challenge. These people are dealing with and working using grain-fed agriculture. So what are we doing differently in this program? What we've decided is, although the foundation focuses on poor farmers, we've decided we don't want to start at the bottom. We want to start in the middle. And that middle, we're focusing on the mid-sized farmer. And we believe that that mid-sized farmer has the potential to unlock. First is to provide more food to the market, because they have fed themselves, they can put food to the market. Number two is that if we do our job well, and we grow the market through this trust network we're talking about, they're going to have to rely on somebody else to supply those markets. And so by starting in the middle, we believe we can have a cascading effect. And that cascading effect will force the mid-sized farmer to look backwards to smallholder farmers who can serve as outgrowers in order for us to serve this market. We're also looking at them because they can become our strategy for sustainability. Why is sustainability important? In order for us to grow large numbers, sustainability and scale are absolutely important. If you're to scratch the surface of the challenge of agriculture in Africa, scale, if you cannot achieve scale, you cannot do anything. If you cannot achieve scale, you will remain where we are now with food insecurity, poor nutrition, and oftentimes what you see about Africa is children who are not getting enough food, and we have to get past that. That is our challenge that was thrown to us by Gunhild this morning. So what are we doing as a foundation using the tools that we have, this amazing infrastructure we have of a bank that is now in five countries, expanding to 15 countries, that has set itself a target of 100 million people to change 100 million people's lives in the next 10 years. We are saying that we are developing a sustainable, a scalable model that is cost efficient, that's cost effective, that at the core of it is looking at how we can support and sustain farmers so that we can transform agriculture on the continent of Africa. And that last slide says we are, in concert with the bank, partnering with them to touch 100 million lives, 13 million in sub-Saharan Africa through agriculture. We believe it can be done. We have amazing partners who have worked with us to get there, the Netherlands government, the Republic of Kenya government, and many of the partners and players you know that are very active in the agriculture sector. But we're trying to do it differently. We're saying we're in this for the long haul, we're in this for scale, we're in this for sustainability, and we are going to use an enterprise engine and a social impact engine to drive change. And we are going to be moving to 15 African countries with a bank in the next 10 years. Thank you very much.